stargazing tent. I don't know where I'm supposed to park. Hold on. You can't see the stars because, you know, I'm filming with my phone, but here is my stargazing tent. I got this gray one, but it has like a little window view. I'm gonna go inside now. I have a whole bed. You look up to the stars. There's a space heater. And there's also a heated blanket, she said, that will last for 10 hours. So, surprise, I just finished my meditation with my Airbnb host. She's awesome. She's amazing. And she told me I can actually sleep in this big one, this middle one with the lights. So, I will show you guys. This is the inside. Ooh. This is amazing. Oh my god. Here's the light. Oh, there's like a little fireplace. And she said that can turn off with no visual. There's even an outlet here. And here's where you'll see all the stars, which you can't see because I am shooting on iPhone. But yeah, this is where I'm going to be sleeping tonight. I'm so excited. Good days. Lights out. Always inside. Good day, living in my mind. Told me I'm on my fears, my dilemma. Chances I disappear if you live. This is where I slept last night. Way to dip, way to kill the food. No, you like that sinking. Stargazing bubble was such a good experience. Like, it was so beautiful and you could see so much of the stars. Like, I was amazed. Like, I was a little concerned because on the highway when I was driving, it was a little cloudy and I couldn't see any stars, but I mean, it's also like a bunch of light pollution. But like, in this location where her stargazing bubbles are, is like the perfect location. Like, it was perfectly clear, you could see all the stars, and it was so beautiful. And like, yeah, there was a heated blanket, there was a heater, like I was fine. It was great. I even brought in an extra blanket just cause. But yeah, so I had the stargazing bubble, and then there's also a little studio room with another bed and bathroom, and you also have that when you book. So you have a toilet you can use, and you're not just like stuck in the bubble. Like, you could sleep in the studio room, but why would you want to do that if you could look up at the stars? I brought an extra blanket from there just to be extra warm because I get cold easily. Like, I love stargazing, and one of the things is that I'm usually freezing cold when I'm stargazing, so it was really nice to have a blanket and an outlet where I could charge my phone. Like, that was really convenient. In person, it was amazing. I saw so many stars. I was hoping to see a shooting star, but I fell asleep. I was so warm and comfortable, and like, the stars were just beautiful, and it was amazing to wake up to a gorgeous sunrise. It was like, it was good. I tried looking for other stargazing bubbles or something similar in Arizona, and there's nothing. That was the only one. So I highly recommend it, and the host is super awesome. Like, she's super sweet, and she even hosts meditations, which I did with her. And yeah, it was just beautiful property, beautiful stargazing bubbles. Like, it was an awesome experience. She also has a stargazing bubble in Sedona. I didn't try that one out, but the one in Camp Verde was like really, really good. I really liked it there. And it's nice and tucked away, and I feel very safe, so I didn't have a problem. Like, I wasn't like I wasn't like freaking out or anything. I felt very comfortable. I highly recommend. Sorry if my vlogs suck. I don't really care. It's just enjoy if you want, or if you enjoy, cool. All right.